Small love, small love.
Small love.
But yeah, like the thing is, I guess I have mixed feelings. Like, partly I want my face all over the internet, and partly I don't care, just as long as like one or two people watch.
Okay, like I actively didn't, like I don't want anybody kind of recognizing me.
Yeah.
Not that like your videos are just gonna get super famous, but like just I know kind of weird coincidences have happened.
Yeah. Well, you know, I was experiencing paranoia in the summer that everyone was looking at me and they knew something about me.
Yeah.
And my psychiatrist said, like, actually that might not be paranoia.
Yeah.
And there's a Doug Stanhope joke where he says, the worst thing a psychiatrist can tell you is not only are the voices in your head real, but they're accurate.
Thank you.
if you think about the people who first got into newspapers, newspapers were probably local, and they probably said, like, oh, Jeff and Suzanne got married today.
Yeah.
And it evolved into this thing where it's like, every day it's like, some horrible event happened.
Yes. I think small town newspapers are still like that.
Yeah. But I'm just thinking, like, if I'm in, like, medieval village or small town newspaperville, in terms of, like,
my level. Keep in mind, nobody could read in medieval times. we can't read, nobody can read.
But what I'm saying, like, right now everything's flowers and sunshine, but what if there's a, like, very dark hole that I'm falling into by learning guitar?
I don't think you are.
No, I don't.
The contrary to popular belief, learning to play guitar well does not make you addicted to heroin.
No, but I have been having times in the past week where I'll be playing guitar and I'll just really want to praise Satan.
Well, that's good.
And it's a joke.
Satan is the patron saint of guitars.
No, it's a joke, but, like, I'm, like, consistently praising Satan.
Like, that's good. I'm sure he is very hot.
Thank you. had a thought.
What is your thought?
Okay, so you know how I was basically raised atheist or like non-believer or whatever?
Mm-hmm.
So what if like Christianity is so clever and complex and out to get me that Satan is not...
Are you doing this for like the video for effect? Or are you actually freaked out by these thoughts?
These are legitimate thoughts, but I'm also recording.
Okay,
Satan, Christianity is so, like, insidious that, to non-believers, the Christians say to the non-believers, oh, we fear Satan, Satan's the great evil one. But in actual Christianity, if you read the Bible and understand that Satan is close to God,
actually, that is what they teach us at church. We're not supposed to tell you guys. Yeah. That whole like, you know, drinking Jesus' blood. It's not Jesus' blood. We totally sacrifice babies.
Oh.
I drink a lot of baby blood in my day.
Your voice is a little bit more deadpan than what I would consider you capable of. I'm the drug fiend in the book, and I'm having lots of sex, and I'm smoking. In real life, I'm smoking pot, and it's fun, and it's cool.
The book.
I don't think the book even mentions Satan.
Yeah.
Anyways, that was creepy. you heard the.
Yes.
Anyways. My parents were throwing out books, and they specifically asked me if I wanted to keep that one.
Because they want to indoctrinate
you
into Satan.
I don't... Well, you know they have Mein Kampf, and it's on my...
I saw that.
Yeah, it's on my shelf.
I kind of want to read it.
You can read it if you want.
I don't know, but I also don't want to have read it.
No, but the thing is, like, if I wanted to get rid of it, I can't just take it to the library.
Because I'll be all like, why are you? But you can leave it in a library.
And I can't just give it to some random guy because, for all I know, like, he's
going to grow up to be the next Hitler.
Or, like, actually, he's an actual Nazi. And I don't want to help actual Nazis.
So you should probably keep it just to keep.
Yeah,
Nazis
I have to keep
it.
Or, like, bury it or something. But, I can't burn it. Because, like, you know the guy who burned Qurans? This was a few years ago. Like there was some war somewhere, and the guy was like, I hate Muslims, and he got everyone to burn Qurans. The same thing happened with Beatles records.
Yeah. And that's 2 Fahrenheit
451. Well, the point is, when you do that, you're just giving more power to the book.
Oh, totally, yeah.
So I can't burn it.
So just keep it.
Yeah.
I think it's a conversation piece.
Yeah. say something else?
Mm-hmm.
Because, okay, I'm learning Nirvana, and I have a very complex relationship with Nirvana,
mm-hmm.
because everyone who, like, gets into conversations with music with me references Nirvana just because of the way I dress.
Okay.
And I have listened to Nirvana. Like, I used to have a lot of MP3s, and I would smoke pot and just listen all day to music. Like,
mm-hmm.
So I had my Nirvana phase. Fair enough. But there's a lot more than Nirvana.
Yeah.
But Nirvana has been, like, pedestaled. Like, I don't think since, like, the 70s did the media do to a group what they, like, there was no Nirvana in the 80s. The 60s and 70s had, like, Hendrix and Jim Morrison.
You could probably argue with these things, but I'm too tired to argue.
Anyway, yeah, Ian Curtis, but that's 20.
No.
Anyways, So I have to, like, whenever the topic of Nirvana is brought up, I have to, like, steer it away from that, because I want to show people that I know more about music than this incredibly cliched band.
Which is kind of sad that they're now that.
Anyway. Yeah. But at the same time, I remember being, like, 8 years old, or however old I was, and going to my friend's house, and they were listening to Nirvana, and I was like, what's that? And they're like, oh, it's nothing, and they turned it off.
Because they didn't want anybody to hear of it.
Like, Nirvana was actually a legitimately interesting and cool band.
Yeah.
Before, I don't know.
Before what?
I don't know what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
Before they were, like, glorified, or, you know.
I know, they become, the myth has become bigger than that. Just too bad. Thank you.